tell you?
My phone's
recording. Hello, my name is Zoey. We built this awesome game.
That's Zoey, and we're using the Discovery Kids Construction Fort. It's a 72-piece build-and-play set.
Yes, it is. We build like a giant rocket ship. Tell it about him.
See?
Really? Look,
and so far, we've built this giant rocket ship.
We'll be right back.
right there. You don't see him?
Oh, wow. I see him.
I don't want to disturb him too much. I want him to eat. I don't want to disturb him too much. But bald eagle eating the deer on the side of the road. That's always awesome to see.
Oh, I got him.
I was making sure I was covering all the addresses, so that way it's not, dun, dun, dun. I'm excited. Ha, oh yeah. That's awesome. That's awesome. I like that.
Oh, that's soft.
Yeah, it's soft. That's awesome. Gotta put that on. I'm gonna try it on, man. Yeah! Have to put it through the steering wheel. That's awesome. I like it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, four wheeling it, man.
Woo!
I don't want to set that straight on the ground. You want me to grab that? No? Thank you.
Oh, I bet it's in the house. Dang it.
I'm finding something for now. Can I use a scoop, scoop? What can I use a scoop? What can I use a scoop, scoop? What can I use a scoop? What can I use a scoop? There's a 2 liter underneath there. Grab that underneath, under behind that bag, underneath the heater, underneath the firebox.
Oh, it's got stuff in it.
Just here, use the beer bong. Why not? Here. Just kink the end off like you're taking a beer bong. Scoop some feet up in there. Alcohol has grains in it, right? I mean,
that's not gonna be enough.
Hell, if it ain't, that's a shit ton. It's just my boot. Go get another scoop. Putting that at? Got any eggs? Got one egg? Got one egg?
Good girl, good girl.
Something about leaving this out here. While we go get Zoey.
You came to where you're gonna put it. No,
I was going to put feed down there and put it so they're like right up on it.
Go ahead, just don't peck at it, so. I put it on the ledge, the brick is, and point it down at them.
Nah, I want it like right up on it.
I'm
getting that. Oh, We got surprises for you and the kitties. So, your first surprise. Craft stuff, some extra craft, and these. Check those out. That's it. Oh. We gotta wait to use them, but we got those too. Oh yeah, pepper seeds and spinach seeds. Oh yeah.
We start opening this.
And for the kitties, we got these. Chicken, catnip, and cheddar flavor.
Hey.
Where's the kitties
there,
at?
There's two of that. Seems a lot better. Like, he knows
it's
the
parts,
and see he's
out of trouble. Hold on. Here, open that up. Oh, you gotta tear this off.
Hold on. Okay, here, let me help.
Nice.
Well, let them eat. They're eating their food.
I want them to try these, though. I want them to try one. Look, there's three different kinds. See, look. Look at the bag, Zoe. There's three different kinds.
Kitties!
See if we can look at them and tell. Let's get a couple different ones. There's a lot of those. Whatever that one is. And then there's one. There's that one. I'm looking to see if I can tell the difference in them. Maybe these. Maybe that's it. Okay, so look. Here we go. I'm guessing these are the three different kinds.
Yeah.
So find three more.
Can I get some for me?
Hold on, Zoey. No, you don't need none for
you. Put the rest back in there. There's three for Khaleesi. Whoa. You're spilling them. You like that food? Look, you can grab these three for either Khaleesi or Jafar. Oh, damn. These are like snacks. These are not.
over, man.
Stories and beer with a bunch of people. Nice.
Gay.
Why is my butt soft?
I feel like I'm on a talk show.
You are on a talk show.
Dear.
Shout out to Yingling for 178 years of brewing.
That's a long time.
5 generations. Shout out to y'all. That's pretty awesome.
That is pretty fucking awesome.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
5 generations.
Even whenever I go out to eat,
178 years of brewing beer, dude. Or like a lager. I don't know. I mean, I'm not some like
Yingling, but I got a dog
beer
fish.
Aficionado. Dogfish?
Mm-hmm.
I can't do the IPAs and shit.
I can't do it, but I'd much rather just drink a Yingling.
IPA is like something I try as like an experiment.
That Ocean City trip told me like Fireball.
Paige, I'm gonna get you some Fireball, and I'm gonna get you like slam drunk. Like you, you are good.
I will.
Fireball goes down way too easy.
I'm gonna die.
You gotta wait. Bryce,
I know.
Y'all gotta wait to drink until you're with us after you have a baby.
What?
You gotta wait to drink. You can wait a year after you have a baby.
What are you mumbling?
I said they gotta come over here before Paige drinks for the first time after she has the baby.
She's gonna breastfeed though.
Yeah, but
she can pump. Before that, and then pump it out after she drinks. Like she's got
it works like that?
Yeah, it works like that.
Google that shit, bro.
Mm-hmm.
It's real shit.
Yeah.
There's actually, like, booby tab tests that they can take to see if there's the alcohol
tests?
Percentages in the milk. Mm-hmm. To see if there's any alcohol.
Can I drink it with the alcohol in it?
Is that considered eggnog?
Yeah.
If it's Christmas time,
That's interesting. But, you know, you think the babies really can get drunk off that? I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, you said that. You said that.
Everything you drink goes through.
Yeah.
So if then I gave that to him.
Like if you ate
that's an interesting thought.
Like if you ate something spicy, the baby could get heartburn after breastfeeding.
Because it'll have like
broccoli or is
hot it, sauce.
Broccoli
well,
gives
I
you gas.
So.
Broccoli makes some gas.
He said, bro, you're getting the hot sauce in your titty milk. Sorry about your life.
Yeah,
fucking Taco Bell package straight
sure
on the nipple.
Broccoli makes the baby gassy. So does onions. Like the onions or broccoli, it makes the baby gassy.
So whatever you were craving through your whole pregnancy.
I didn't really crave anything. My mom like ate a bunch of
anchovies.
That was one
and
time.
Like, there, I don't like cherries, but there's this one type of cherry that my mom eats or ate while she was pregnant, and that's the only cherry I like. I don't like any other type of cherry.
Fuck with cherries.
I don't like cherries, man. I don't like fresh cherries. I don't like cherry flavored stuff.
I ain't talking about that shit. I'm talking about sour cherries.
I don't like the malt shit.
Sour cherries are the shit. That was the favorite plant in my backyard.
Chocolate covered cherries? We got chocolate covered cherries today.
Those are dank.
I like the stuff with the flavor.
Yeah. The things that have the red shit in there.
What the fuck?
The malt something or whatever.
I know what you're talking about,
Paige. I don't know what they're called, but
they're
really disgusting.
Truffles?
I don't know.
I like cherries.
I like turtles.
Cherries are okay.
I don't like fake artificial cherries.
Yeah.
Like, if you go to Walmart and you get those big bags of dark cherries. You know, like bags that come in grapes. I love those.
Yes, those are good.
And I love the dark cherries.
I like
white cherries.
Yeah. I don't want it.
Like, I called him back one day and was like, hey man, sorry, but I'm gonna take another job, man. I got a job elsewhere. I'm going to, he's like, oh yeah, what is it? What are you doing, man? And I was like, I'm gonna go work at a vape shop. And he's like, a vape shop? Really? And I was like, yeah, go work at a vape shop. He's like, okay, well, call me if that doesn't work out, man. Yeah, I'll talk to you later. He's like, shit, he thought it was silly. Shit. That's one of the best decisions I've ever made, man. Shit, I'm telling you what, that is magic.
Stop. Keep your hands to yourself if you want to. Stop. Why are you not being mean to me now? You are.
You can't be mean when you're handicapped, bro. Like too wounded, man.
I'm taking my handicap too. So we're kind
of
like just.
If y'all got in a fight on a flight of steps, that should be so funny.
That would be bad.
I mean, it would. I'm sorry. That sounded really fucked up. Like, that wouldn't be funny, but like, I was thinking more like comic book shit.
Yeah.
I was thinking like silly. Yeah. Because this guy's fucking wounded. Anything out, you see what I'm saying?
With crowbars.
Yeah. Something. 3 foot.
Those giant, like, cotton swab things.
Dude, did you ever used to play the game when you were a kid? It was a motorcycle game for Sega Genesis. And you drove a motorcycle and you could pick up weapons and earn weapons. And they'd be like a piece of chain or a baseball bat. And you could, it was called Road Rash 3D.
Yes, uh-huh.
And you could beat the people beside you while you're racing, dude.
Yes.
Yo, it was a wild
game,
dude.
Man,
that was cool.
That's an old game.
I didn't take your seat. I took my seat.
No, stop putting my stuff right there, man.
That's crazy.
Road Rash 3D.
That's an old ass game. I miss Mario Kart.
Mario Kart. She loves Mario Kart. She's a beast on some Mario Kart. I would love, that's one thing I'm going to find is like old game systems. If you guys find one for like a really good deal or you know somebody or see one somewhere for like cheap, like, mm-hmm. you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I ain't going to pay out to ask for one. Yeah. But I'm definitely down to buy some old game systems. Like that's what I'm, it's, that is so weird that that PlayStation, only PlayStation, like, it's a PS2, only plays PS1 games. Sums up with it. It's a PS2.
They assumed its gender.
That's exactly what it was.
Factory.
That's a 2016 PS2. What the fuck that is.
Oh, I'm not a PlayStation 2. I'm a PS1.
It's upset.
I refuse to play.
Go stick a safety pin through one of the cords, maybe it'll work. You're like, okay, now that you understand.
It needs a safe space.
It's got it right under my TV.
That's really funny though. That's pretty
That's
cool.
So fucked up because that's like how I'm feeling about it.
Yeah. Poor thing.
How about the falafel?
What is it? Yeah, talk some shit about what it was.
Falafel.
Yeah, I would have picked the bangers and mash.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna pick, but anyway, I'm gonna go.
I don't know, but it's gotta be good.
Subwoofers and potatoes. It is. Dirty Sound remixes subwoofers and potatoes.
Alright, let's
wake up in the morning like.
It should be drums and
mash,
because it's.
That's a banger, man. That's fucking 15s or something.
Hey, let me ask you a question.
Bangers and mash is sausage and onion gravy.
Ooh, I love it.
That sounds really good. I'm down for some bangers and mash. Damn. What was it? Sausage and onion gravy?
Yep. I don't know what to make.
Was it what? Mashed potatoes or something?
Yeah.
Dude. Bangers and mash. All right.
Well, I don't mention this. Bryce, which gets hotter? A black light bulb or a regular light bulb? If you leave a black light. Bulb. If you leave a black light on for an hour, can you touch it? Could you touch it, Paige? Have you ever touched a black light that's been on for an hour? Yeah, light bulb. Can you touch the light bulb after it's been on for an hour?
No.
See, but you've never touched a black light.
I never touched a black light either. I asked me.
You would think the black one would get hotter because of the black one. You know what I mean?
But it's not really like black.
My light bulb question the other day was what's.
It's your choice.
Yeah, shut up. What's brighter than.
Your balls are dropping.
Yeah, finally, dude, finally. Only you knew. But, what's brighter, the light bulb or a light bulb's reflection? Because a glare is.
Not a good one.
A glare is supposedly 8 times brighter.
It's the reflection.
But that's of the sun.
But it's the reflection because you can see the reflection all the way to my room of the light.
That doesn't matter.
So is the reflection just as bright?
I would have to bet that it's actually to the eye, to the naked eye, just as bright. On a mathematical scale, I would have to say that it would be slightly dimmer. And the reason I say that is because I would think that it would lose some of its particles along the way. Right? Like, wouldn't as light travels, and that's why after a certain distance you can't see.
It's not going through, it's bouncing back.
It doesn't matter, it's traveling. It doesn't matter what it's bouncing off of. I mean, eventually, yes, in the bounce
where
off
did,
of.
Where did they get lost at?
On the travel.
On the travel.
On the travel. Seriously, when light travels from A to B, it loses particles. And this is why I think that would be so. I may be wrong. And
yeah, are they lost or scattered?
But
they're lost and scattered at the same time.
So check this out.
It's not lost. They're just being something. They're not as close.
So the reason I say that.
They're still there.
Scattered.
They're just not in one spot. Scattered. So you can't see them as much as they would if they weren't scattered. So,
and the reason I say that is because if you take the light and shine it like a flashlight, and you're like, damn, my flashlight don't reach the moon. But I come over with some super duper fucking laser that reaches the moon. You know what I mean? And I can shine a light on the moon. You see what I'm saying? Your flashlight wasn't bright enough. It didn't have enough particles to reach.
Okay, when you're looking at the light in the mirror, you're looking at the reflection of the light, not of the light's path where the light is actually scattered, which is why it gets lost. Right? That's not what you're looking at. You're looking at the actual. So. If you're looking at the actual light in the mirror, what's getting lost? Because there's no trail.
It got to the mirror, didn't it? If the light's over here, the mirror's right here. And then you're standing over here. Right? Like in my eyes, okay? I'm looking at the mirror, right? The light's over here. The light shines. It travels from the bulb to the mirror. Reflects off the mirror to my eyesight because I'm looking at it. I connected my eyesight to the mirror to that point. Contact, right? The light traveled from here to here and then from here to here. So that's the distance. Okay. So the light at some point lost some. Now it's gonna vary depending on how far you are from it. You know what I mean? If you shine the light on Earth and the mirror's on the moon and I'm back on the other side of the Earth and you reflect that and bounce that.
But it's a reflection. You're not looking at its travel.
You have to. If you're asking what's brighter, it would be the base form of light of what the light come from.
Alright, whatever.
Right?
No, that's not what I think.
Then what then, please?
Well, I guess I was just kind of asking your opinion. I don't know whether, I don't think it's going to be less bright. I think it's either going to be more or equal.
Why would it be more? Why would it multiply? What would cause it to multiply? I would think, and the reason I say that is
because
the
if that's that considered a glare?
Well, the reason I say that is because as it made contact, depending on what substance or what surface it was bouncing off of, certain substances absorb light more than others.
Like if you're outside, you're driving your car, okay, and the car in front of you.
So I guess it bases it off of what are you reflecting it off of.
But is the reflection of the sun off of a mirror different than a light bulb off of a mirror? I feel like
the sun versus a light bulb. Fuck yeah, the sun's brighter.
Yeah. Because I feel like.
Okay. So is the sun's reflection? Yeah. Brighter than the sun?
I can.
So
I can,
does that make the light bulb's reflection of the light bulb brighter or no?
No.
How is it not?
It makes it less.
How?
Because I just explained it to you.
How's that any different between the sun's light travel?
Yeah, because the sun.
Because it travels. Do you see what I'm saying?
But then again, the sun isn't a light bulb.
But the sun both, is more but they're powerful. Both a light source, and those light
the
sources travel.
The sun is way more powerful than any light source we have.
Okay. A sun that's millions of miles away on a car mirror rather than a mirror that's 2 feet away from a mirror hanging off of your window. Or off the wall. Window. Off the wall. That's pretty difference in how far the light has to travel.
You're looking at two total different, like, you're putting a tank up against a slingshot. You're
no,
like, you're like let me call in the U.S. Navy to go to war against the Harlem Globetrotters.
No, I'm just using it as a comparison. I'm not saying that it's not.
You see what I'm saying? The amount of energy, and it's a different type of light source, too. That's where that's the difference in it. Between the sun and a light bulb. That's why the sun is better. As far as, or brighter. You're getting more lumens. You're getting more lumens from the sun than you are from the light bulb.
You know what I don't agree with? The whole, if it was dark in here, that everything would not be the color that it is right now. I think that is such shit.
It's black.
No, it's not.
If it's not.
That lighter right there would still be blue if all these lights are off. It would still be blue. And I know it would because when you turn on the lights, it's blue. And it still would be blue
in
the dark.
That's because it's absorbing the blue from the spectrum from
no,
that
it's not.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Yes,
it
is.
Whatever.
That's it. If you turn that fucking light off, you can't see it. The lighter is black, right?
If the absence.
It's not absorbing any light to obtain a color.
Black. Okay, let me explain to you. White and black are technically not colors.
Yeah, I know. They're
okay.
Like whatever.
White is all colors.
I understand
the
theory. I know the
so
theory.
If you have no
I don't
light,
believe it.
If you have no light to illuminate anything, then no matter what it is, then there's nothing to light it up to create a light spectrum in the object. If you have the absence of something, okay, for example, a 14-year-old kid that just did the fucking speech the other day on the TED Talk, talked about, you could put me and Michael Jordan side by side. Give us both a basketball, but only tell me that I can take one shot. Who's got a better chance at making a shot, me or Michael Jordan?
Michael Jordan.
Me. Because I get to take a shot.
He knows it.
So the absence of something means that you don't even have the capability of doing something.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? Yeah. So therefore, if you took all light source from an area is what they're talking about, not if you turn the light off in the room. Because there's still light coming in from the moon, the stars, from the other TV, you see what I'm saying? There's still light leaking in the room somewhere. If you had the absence of light, there would be no way to shoot a light particle into any object to illuminate it to create the illusion of it being a specific color. You see what I'm saying? The reason that things look at a specific color is because, like he was saying, they divide a certain piece of the light and hold it in, and they reflect that certain light. That's what creates our visual spectrum of that's blue, that's
then
red.
I don't understand
this is
how
brown,
like
this is
they
brown.
Create like different colors and shit.
Because there's
like that makes zero sense to me. Like, oh yeah, I'm gonna put this pigment in this paint, but oh, I'm just like messing with some like pigments that don't have any fucking color. So what the fuck am I putting in here?
So because the pigments, if you're mixing paints and stuff, or so, as far as any type of then whatever color you're looking for. When you, we know that the specific pigments that we add to things create, okay, if I add this pigment, it makes it blue. If I add this pigment, it makes it green. If I add this pigment, it makes it yellow.
Yeah, but we
if I mix the
light.
Green and the yellow pigment together, ta-da-da, you see what I'm saying? Like you.
Yeah, get, no, I get, I know how we make color, but like, we need light, or I just don't, I think it's shit.
Sorry to disappoint you.
It's okay. So I'm still going to go on believing that I can see color in the dark.
Alright, so now what about this one, okay? There's another one. Alright, so all around the world right now, no matter what time it is, there are cars on the road, yeah, there's traffic, there's noise everywhere. You know?
Okay.
There's traffic, there's yeah. noise, right? All around the world. We would walk outside, it would be dead quiet, right? It would
mm-hmm.
be super quiet.
Yep.
If there was absolutely nothing but like silence in the world, no traffic, no outside noise, no nothing, would you be able to tell a difference?
Huh. That's a good one. Like if there was a if we walked outside right now, it'd be quiet.
Right.
But like if the whole world was quiet and we walked outside,
would you know?
Would it be like
would it
more
be like
quiet?
More quiet?
That's a good one. That's a good thought.
I think
so.
That the vibrational frequency.
Because sound always travels so far, you know?
Yeah. But energy never stops, so it falls into another form of vibration. So eventually you feel slight vibrations that we no longer pick up because we pick them up since we're a baby and an infant, but we feel it all the time, such as the earth moving and everything like that. You know what I mean? And we no longer feel those things because they're so natural to us that we don't second guess ever. It's more of a natural reaction to feel the vibration of the rest of the world. So I think it wouldn't be nonetheless of a hearing thing, but I think it'd be more of a feeling thing.
Yeah, that's true too. Yeah,
you
like
see
it would
what
just
mean?
Feel
like
weird.
I think it would
yeah.
feel eerie and awkward.
Yeah.
One thing I've been looking into and wanting to do
that's
is
it like the it's probably like the opposite of an earthquake.
Is these saltwater tanks. These isolation saltwater
yeah,
tanks.
Yeah, that was a good one.
That's what... Okay, so...
Yeah, where they, the people, like, lay in them or whatever. And
you go
what
in, and I think there's, like, some of them have seats. I mean, all the tanks
yeah,
are probably
yeah.
slightly different. But basically, it's like a saltwater tank full of water up to, like, here. You know, up to your chest area. Pretty much submerged damn near the whole way. And... It's completely black, sealed off, soundproof to the max. Like, you cannot hear. And you go in there for, like, a couple hours, and supposedly when you come out, you have, like, a whole nother outlook on life. Like, you have a total different... Like, you go into a translucent state, or a trans... Dude, you fucking start tripping, damn near. And apparently have, like, serious epiphany of what life really means, and, or, from what I understand. You know, this is from what I've seen, what I've read.
That's like going into a room with a faucet just like tip.
Yeah,
that's
tip.
Torture.
Yeah.
That's torture. Dude.
That's crazy.
What about that house that you got to sign a waiver to go into? That scary. That horror
yep.
house.
We were looking last year or a year before, something like that. We were looking at a bit of a... We were we're looking up in a bunch of different places to go, like, for Halloween, like, haunted places, haunted scary houses, trails, wagon rides, whatever, different places like that. We came across one, I want to say it's in Pennsylvania, and you have to sign a waiver to even, like, go on the property, because, like, the chances of you getting injured are pretty severe. And it's not like a haunted house, like, people are out there trying to scare you. Like, the place is really that fucked up. Like,
but there is work
for you. I would like to go to some place like that. Like, I like adventure in abandoned places. Like, growing up, there used to be this abandoned farm back in the woods, man. And they used to, and like, everybody used to go there and party. I mean, that was like the known random, everybody could randomly have a party there. It's way back in the woods. I mean, two-story house, abandoned fucking house, do whatever you want, kick a hole in the wall, leave your trash, doesn't fucking matter. Mm-hmm. Two fucking teenagers burning that shit down. You want to talk about piss, dude? Those dudes got the shit kicked out of them for like the next couple months, dude. Every time they came back to school, they got beat up the day they came back to school. Like, and I don't mean just like punched in the face and roughed up. I mean like fucking stomped the fuck out. Like, dude, you fucked up a spot where like it was the chill spot and you fucked it up. You know what I mean? Like, that's shit. Right.
Where did they go? Where the fuck are they doing?
Did they really? They didn't tell nobody?
They what? No, they were saying.
That's pretty shitty.
And they just up and left.
That's not very nice.
Well,
at least I didn't tell
them anything. What?
Well, that didn't reach this side of the sofa or Ryan, apparently.
That's so fucking...
I don't have the money to give me anything. I'm not getting hurt. I don't want her to buy me. You know, I'm not trying to get her to give me anything. She was telling me she told... Because they was over here whispering. She was like, I'm about to go home. Because they take me right there. And I looked at her and said, pick me up something on your way back. She's like, are you seeing how much money I got? I was like, I'm just checking.
That's so fucked up. We just had like a 30-minute conversation about how we all want Rofo. Damn. Shasty fuckers, dude. Like.
Lock him out.
You know what?
I
didn't
want to.
This is the type of shit that makes the hood go crazy.
Just out of fucking GP, man. That's nice. And this is going. This is going on YouTube. You can watch how it fucking unfolded, bro. You can see it live action. You old Rofo trip taking on a secret tip take, motherfucker. On the tip tape. Tip tape on the tiptoe out the fucking door.
Drip drop.
Yeah, what was it? Drip drop. Drop top. Fuck that shit. Like, I don't know.
Fuck this shit.
Oh, whatever. I paid the price to get
Rofo
on my home.
I know, we're the ones stuck without fucking Rofo. And that's still a dick move on them because that's still like slightly out of their way, kind of. Not funny. Too much.
No, we pass a rope. We pass a rope.
Well,
now,
fuck
like...
y'all too then.
Twice.
Yeah, we did. We passed two
y'all
rofos.
Can watch this twice. Dicks. I'm like rofo motherfucker. I'm about to go to the kitchen, start cooking cookies and bacon and fucking everything delicious.
So I got scrapple pierogies and other.
I got scrapple. I got liver mush. I got all types of shit.
Liver mush sounds.
Yeah. We got mussels.
Really.
Oh, yeah, we do. We still have those.
Yeah. You can keep the muscles. I'm good on them.
Well, I told y'all I was staying at night. I mean,
you ate the fucking head. I'll be over here with bacon wrapped cookies in a minute.
Bacon wrapped cookies. That doesn't even sound nice.
Shit. Sweet and salty, yeah. It's gonna be a fucking magnificent.
Well, like, you know what? No, that might be. Oh my gosh, y'all want to know what's good? Deep fried bacon dipped in gravy.
This sounds like a heart attack.
You know, chocolate covered bacon is really good.
Oh, but a bacon wrapped chocolate chip cookie sounds like shit.
Yeah, that was kind of like contradictory.
If you put the chocolate on the outside of the bacon, it's fucking delicious.
So why don't you make cookies with bacon?
I ain't making nothing for none of y'all.
Ryan's that salt guy. You know that salt guy?
Damn. This is why I'm getting real fun with them. My beard.
That's the meme of the month.
Yeah. No, that's the meme at the start of 2000. That guy that's like...
Wandissimo.
I was waiting for him to cut his finger off. Like, that's what I was waiting when he was like cutting the fucking meat off the thing. I was,
yeah, he was like,
I watched the video before I actually saw the meme.
And I was waiting for him to like.
Yeah. I haven't watched the video or saw the meme, so I'm lost.
You haven't seen it?
You haven't seen the video?
Yeah, the guy is super funny.
That looks like an oriental version of me with his hair in a ponytail and he's like cutting it.
Oriental version of you, nigga? Are you kidding me? it looks like
an oriental version of me.
He's not oriental though.
If he isn't.
He's not, I promise you. He's not, is he?
Are you kidding me?
Definitely that's not Oriental. Hold up, okay. We're gonna
look
at this man.
Ryan, you could be Oriental.
That's true.
You could be Oriental.
Yeah, I agree.
Yes, you could.
Like if you like taped your eyes back a little bit.
That's just a ninja.
Man bun, chopsticks, braided, robe.
Yeah, I agree. You'd be like that rabbit.
Like Bruce Pryor.
Hey, I like it.
I like BP, it. Son.
I just walk around with nunchucks all the time.
This guy, here we go.
Figured he looked like he was like an islander of some sort, maybe. Some oriental islander. I may be wrong. Excuse me if I am, I'm not trying to offend nobody. Yeah, that fucking guy. Did you see him?
I just read the video.
Yeah, I know. He does
not. If you see the video, you'll see what I was talking about.
Oh,
child. Oh,
there's monsters
in there.
Take
your sock off. I will take your sock off. Hey, I'll do it to you too. You better call me.
Please don't.
Think you and fucking gimpy
foot
over there and fucking
exclude
it. I'll do this bandage.
Do it. I've been thinking about doing it on this. I simply haven't put it back on. Right.
I can put it back on.
Too late now.
Maybe it's too late now.
We should all just go to sleep. They come back. We're all rock. We're all asleep. Leave Rofa at the door, I'll see you tomorrow. Leave a note on the window.
Chickens are keeping warm.
I'm putting my back windows on tomorrow. I have to.
Where are you doing that at?
Probably my dad's. I might be at my parents' house. Because I can just pull it into the garage and he's got all that shit.
Yeah.
And
slide these couches back. Okay. Can you get the fuck off me? Now? Please?
Don't laugh.
It's, well, it's funny. It's like something I'd say to you.
Keep on kicking me. You'll find out.
I'm not very sure of my.
Damn, it wasn't even recording the whole time.